What it look like? How you feeling?
Oh, I'm feeling pretty cool, me.
Now, you know, I had to, reach out. You know, BG just dropped a song stating that you died, man.
Yo.
What was that about? You know, you got to let the people know you're alive and well.
Well, first of all, yeah, this is me, Lava Black, man. You heard me because of a minute, man. Real talk, man. You heard me? Hey, Anjo, man. You already do what you do, man. In general, man. Lava Black and the family, we in the building, man. We ain't doing no tripping, man. Rest in peace because of a minute and all my fallen soldiers out there. Free be stupid and free the real one, man. You already know what I'm out there, man. Feel the rest of the know you, man. It's locked up in Angola, the DCI, man. You know we ain't doing no tripping, but guess what? One day y'all got to feel, so we try to make it so.
For sure. So, what was your reaction, though, when you first heard BG put that in the song?
Yeah, man, that messed me up, man. You know, I don't know what's going on with me. You know, I wake up on my seat. The nigga really can't woke up on my bed. You know, man, tell me, listen to some soldier. You know, man, so I'm checking it out, man, on the music side. And I'm like, hold on, man, it messed me up. So when I get to my tablet, I'm getting buku people hollering at me on my tablet. Just telling me music kicks and all this hip type of things, you know what I'm saying? So I'm listening to it. I'm like, shit, I'm getting mad. And I'm out already. I need to see what's going on with me, you hear me? So my first thing is I need to reach out and get homie on the phone. I need to get Big Feet that nigga on the phone with me. You hear me? So boom, I call Lil Slim and tell Lil Slim. I'm like, look, homie, nephew, where you at? So he tell me where you at. I'm like, look, what you in this up? What's up? I need you to re-rock it. Call EG for me. So he like, what's wrong? I'm like, nah, not wrong. Not yet. The fuck, I need to know what's going on, man. Homie done put me in the song. See, I done got killed in the song. So I'm like, well, nephew like, well, what you mean? I said, man, nephew, the man just put the song out. Then I got killed. I said, man, you must have been here yet. So that made him want to listen to it and all this here. So I'm like, we ain't got time to listen to it. I'm telling you what's real. So I'm on the phone. Will on the phone too. See what I'm saying? Because that's who I had to call. If he listened to this bitch, it's not answering the phone, so that's how I wound up got Willow on the line and got Willow to hit Lil Slim, so that's how the phone call was. So I got Lil Slim to Willow verify, yeah, he heard it and bop, 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 so I had to get Lil Slim to hit that boy on the phone. Look, man, let's get straight to the point, call BG on the phone. So we get him on the phone, but he don't answer. He starts sending text messages saying all this here. So boom, I'm like, well, tell him I'm right here, like, oh, what's him? So, nephew, the man, the message is backwards and forwards. So I said, man, look, tell homie. I said, look, bro, I'm happy home and all this here. Boy, you heard me tell him, I'm right here screaming, oh, for real, I ain't going nowhere, no time soon. Man, you heard me, I'm short as a million in the east, and man, I'm about to get up out here, man. You heard me, but he's going to have a lot of backlash. Once he put this, he don't stop his album, so he ain't stopping. So he's been getting all that. I mean, he ain't getting backlash and everything about the issue. So he been hollering at me, you know, sending me messages and shit through my little nephew, so they're so slim. So I've been like, you know, telling nigga, I understand where he coming from. I feel where he coming from with it, but I know who I am too. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, bro, you hear me? He got to holler at me. He said, you know, some shit is gonna come out, you know what I'm saying? So I'm sitting back waiting, so who fuck? I can't do nothing till I get up out of here.
Right. So do you think it was just a mistake that he made in that song, saying that you got killed?
Say that again?
I said, do you think it was just a mistake that he made in the song, saying that you got killed? Maybe, you know, he...
I think so. At first, I'm thinking that weirdo, because, you know, my little cutthroat is up across the back here, you heard me? So I'm thinking he probably ain't got it mixed up, but I ain't quite get down to that part with him yet. You know what I'm saying? So I'm waiting to see how that's going to turn out, you know? Well, you know, the Crosser did get killed while I was down on this Joe's head, you know what I'm saying? So
right.
He might have been mistaken me. But I was told that they gave him that info about me while I was in the feds. See, I had got killed, you remember? So he said he wound up doing that music while he was in the feds, and when Baby them come got him. Fuck. You remember when he jumped in the studio? You know, Baby done got that top dog studio put me, you remember? So, fuck.
This call is subject to recording and monitoring.
This is a call from an offender at a Louisiana Department of Corrections facility.
So he went on ahead and dropped the album, you know what I'm saying? Got one album out the way, you remember?
Right. Did you have a relationship with BG back in the day?
Yeah, he was popular. You know what I'm saying? You couldn't help but to listen to it. You know what I'm saying? Every call you was listening to, it come out calls and everything, man. So yeah, he was popular, man. You know what I'm saying? I ain't never had no quarrel with him. You know what I'm saying?
Right, because, you know, him and Slim used to run together real tough.
Yeah, they went to elementary school together, man. I don't remember times I done went around there and see Slim up in a high car, man, and see him with them big old lifts and those crooked ass shoes on his feet, man. Girl, man, look at him up and down. But I never knew he was going to be that smoking high like he is now, but that was when he was a baby gangster. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm saying?
Right. And another question people wanted me to ask about was, you know, you online, it's a video on YouTube with you dissing Hot. What happened with that?
Oh, man, shit. I'm a problem solver with me, bro. You remember? So at the end of the day, bro, I'm trying to figure that out, too, you know what I'm saying? Hope when I get out shit, you know what I'm saying, we can go on and see each other, man, you know what I'm saying, and get to the re-rock of it. You know what I'm talking about, you dig?
Mm-hmm.
You know, shit. Make it do what it do, you know what I'm talking about? So fuck me.
Well, did it start?
Oh, I can see about that, you know what I'm saying? But I know homie know me, you know what I'm saying? We go way back from the L.E., you know, I'm a gangster, I know you're a gangster too, you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, it is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, that bitch falling on in the mud, running up 6th Street, you know what I'm saying? Running from the people, you know what I'm saying? By Vanessa Poe, yo. I know a lot about that bitch, just like you know me, girl. Oh, real rap, man, big feet bitch. You already know what's down with me. That bitch used to have a lot of hell in his own. So that bitch had like he know he's the one shave on his own big old bitch.
So did it the rumor is that it started over an argument between Slim and Hot about Cash Money and No Limit. Is that any truth to that?
Well, yeah, I remember that too, man. That bill was fire too. You remember? It was deep, man. It was like 100 people on that Northern Washington, man. You remember? It was on these E-Ports, man. You remember? That's the colorful wall, if y'all don't know what that is. It was on these E-Ports, you remember? And shit, we was deep. I'm talking about Hot and Slim Josie, you remember? And I tell it. Slim, man, bitch, my little dog calling you, wop, beep, 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 wop, wop, wop. So Slim, like, ooh, man, you got me fucked up, man. I run this motherfucking city, man. It's me and all this city. You already know how you rolling. You hear me? It's just me. You see that sign on that corner right here? Look at that sign, Magnolia. Bitch, you know what I'm saying? I'm all this. You know how you roll. You got a hell of a mouth. He's out practically gave it to him. You know what time to see that here. So they back and forward. They ain't telling. My partner telling Hot, man, bitch, chill out, man. Leave your homie alone. You know what I'm saying? Because homie, you know, homie be tripping. So, instead of trying to, like, go with the greatness, like, he driving or something like that in a cell or something, like, he ripping and clowning and shit. So, Slim already in his feelings already because, you know, he keeps some camouflage shit on his mind. So, boom. That is. Bitch, that nigga, I'm told you. Wah, 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 wah. I like, yah, 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 yah. So, at the same time, fuck. You know, it's around all the cutthroats around us, you know what I'm saying? Annoying around us deep. You know what I'm saying? Power and money, all that out there. You know what I'm saying? So while I'm managing, break it up. Yeah, broke it up. I got in the middle of it too, man. Look, y'all, yeah, you're right, man. Ooh, y'all be free with that shit. Yeah. So it's this thing, man. You hear me?
Oh, so they end up actually having a fight.
Everybody was leaving off and shit, man. You hear me? They was getting back into each other's face and wah, 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 wah. So. Slim push Hot, push Slim and some shit, you see, and break it up. But as they walking off, you already know them, the cutthroat is tripping. You know what I'm saying? So, you already know how that goes, you know what I'm saying? On some street shit, you see. Some camouflage shit with the flying everywhere, you heard me? So, you already know them, you see. And that shit was wild, though. I got a lot of stories, man, about the homie, man, about the little homie. I see them, man. That's real nigga been my day, but we still got to, like, So
you
Yellen got it so before too. Up in the nightcap while I was doing a little comedy show at Bang, you heard me?
Mm-hmm.
He had two girls with him. He trying to like get in a comedy show for free. All right, I'm cool with you getting it for free, bitch, you can run away. I don't know the two beautiful ladies you got with you. I ain't letting them in.
This call is subject to recording and monitoring.
This is a call from an offender at a Louisiana Department of Corrections facility.
They with you, man, with me, you see what I'm saying? So, we got a debate going on by the ticket booth. That's my ticket, boo. You heard me? That money comes in my pocket. So the gang ain't having it. I'm gonna let you come in. The ticket's $10. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna, look, I'll let you come in, but that's $20 for them. You know what I'm saying? So this is the big pop. I said, look, man, fuck all that. So we get close to each other for this and all that, so we push each other, then we fall in. You know what I'm saying? You know how that go. You know what I'm saying? The old car, I mean, all the bro taking the money at the boo. She called for my partner, my same partner to the day. Blade came broke up the fight in front of the boo and all this stuff. So y'all know how that go, bro. Magnolia shit, man. UBT, real nigga shit all day. Real rap.
Okay, so you and Hot situation doesn't have to do with Hot and Slim situation?
No.
Okay.
No, at first, because listen, I'm going to come up with me that nigga 818. I've been a frontline nigga day one. Because of me, I'm going to ride a die with that. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, you can say that too. Just out the gate. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to come up with me that nigga. So, at the time, yeah, I'm going to say, yeah, fucking right.
Okay, and the DB, I know we short on time, so I'm kind of jumping all over the place, but tell me something about the DBs. I know they came up under, you know, you and Slim,
man,
for the most part.
Like that, man, that's a real little foot soldiers, man. They gonna make it out, man, no matter what state, wherever we go, man. I'm a real rap, man. Free B shoot, by the way. Man, look, man, shit, I'll be talking to the homie on the joint, man, you hear me? We be running and you there, yeah, you got a lot of shit going, man. I started Law of Black Entertainment, man.
You have 1 minute left.
You know what I'm saying? I started Law of Black Entertainment for a reason, bro, you dig? They have some for the future, man, you dig? Y'all know how this go for the family, that couple committee, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, man.
For sure. I think a lot of people outside of New Orleans' first introduction to you and Be Stupid was on that Hood to Hood DVD.
Well, yeah, we sure was, man. We enjoyed ourselves, too. Look, we had just got out of shootout on that motherfucker, too. Right before that, we was in a shootout before we got in the hallway. That's why I was so amped up and hyped up, too. Because, man, we was on one. But at the end of the day, shit, Law of Black Entertainment been started for a reason. Now, he got a clothing line. He got his own cologne. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, man, he got somewhere to come home and get it back popping, man. Law of Black Entertainment, bro, you know what I'm saying? Along with Bad Girl Clothing. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we gonna make it do what it do, man. You dig? Real rap, man. You feel me?
So y'all was getting it popping right before the you hopped on camera?
Yeah.
Thank you for using Securus. Goodbye.
You mentioned the DBs and Be Stupid, and being on that documentary. What are some of your earliest memories of Be Stupid? Because I know he was a major representative.
I got a bunch of them too, man. Like this time, look, the whole couple committee, we on the app, you heard me? I got a quarter shot on the app, though. They just pumping, you heard me? I got 60 rounds, 150 jumping through the roof. And all of us out, we strapped, you heard me? I'm talking about we strapped. I just had Baby Logger, you heard me? That's my daughter, Samaj. I just had Baby Logger, you heard me? That's what I call all my kids, Baby Logger. Baby Logger 1, Baby Logger 2, Baby Logger 3, Baby Logger 4. You know what I'm saying? So she is Baby Logger 3. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, the people passing, but we get word that the people about to turn them like little me, Be Stupid, Son, Dizzy, Timmy. I'm talking about the whole couple committee. Double crawls a week deep out here, you heard me? And I got just brought my daughter a stroller, and we got nowhere to put all the guns in. The people, they two cars deep about to spin the men on, man. No, it's turning towards you, you heard me? So, fuck, I'm like, man, look, put a big Baby Long a stroller. You know what I'm saying? Baby Long at the top part of the stroller. I got the bottom part of the stroller, you heard me? She got a top in line, so you ain't gonna never water with my mind, you know what I'm saying? So, come on. Man, Baby Logger, we done put like 15 guns in Baby Logger's shoulder. Look what I do. I start walking slow towards Magnolia, where the people got to come towards. So I got away from the rest of the cutthroaters and start walking towards them. I got 40 down to 40 or 20 guns in this motherfucker. I said, I know one thing. The people take this stroller, I'm in a world of trouble, but I know for sure I ain't coming back. Because I know a few of them bitches hot. I know a few of them guns hot as a motherfucker. So, boom. I'm walking slow, but you know I walk with a limp anyway, sir. So I'm walking slow. I'm looking head up at the people when they pull up at the corner. So I turn my shoulder and go up Magnolia, you heard me, from all Washington, you heard me. And I keep walking slow, but you know I walk with a limp. So the people turn,
this
keep going.
This is a call from an offender at a Louisiana Department of Corrections facility.
Guess who didn't win fuck with, dog? The Cutter Committee. They went fuck with all them on their ass, dog. But they just don't know. All the guns just passed them by and destroyed it with me and my daughter. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And guess what, though? Well, I got like 3/4 on me, but they tucked away. You feel me? Already know I got them under this nut. And I'm walking, I'm out of the motherfucker. Man, that shit was crazy. I remember so many stories about us, man. What? Man, federal.
Mm-hmm. Speaking. You know, Soulja Slim had that, you know, put you in that song talking about how you held it down with the Mac like it was a K. What was the story behind that night? What was the, like, what inspired that? What inspired that line for Soulja Slim to say that?
Oh, well, you know, we used to be jumping out and jacking and stealing cars and robbing niggas and shit, man. You know what I mean? Like, shit, I know for sure Slim and Jack half of the know you. You know what I'm saying? So the ones who deserve it. You already know how we roll it, man. Let's go to committee, man. We was going from hood to hood, though, fucking with people and shit. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of sex. Niggas know what they do. You know what I'm saying? Niggas know what they do. I done went to jail for 3 counts on robbery and 2 or 2 murders behind some set. Behind a different set. You know what I mean? We were fucking with. You know what I'm saying? So she was real. You know what I'm saying? Growing up, man. That's all the fuck we did. We had to do the eat, man. You remember? Then we had to follow the second line with Slim Mama every Sunday. So that means we got to stay straight around the clock. And on top of that, we beefing with down to 2 or 3 projects, too. So Slim won't make sure his mama straight in the second line. So we following the second line. 10, 15 niggas, he was going, making sure mom straight. You remember? You know one thing. Shout out to Miss Linda. I love you, mom. You remember? And we 81-80. And she know it, too. Look, we smoking weed and everything. Slim couldn't even smoke weed at this time. Look. But we still going and look, we got low all in the back of the line. I know she got people looking for Slim saying that Slim doing shit bad, but she ain't about it too. She know I had him out of my ear. I miss my homie Soulja Lips. That's what I call him, Soulja Lips.
Yeah, rest in peace, Soulja, man. You know, Gangsta, he on YouTube. He shared a story about the time he got shot and you pretty much saved his life. What can you speak on what happened that night?
That happened in the daytime with him, you remember?
Okay.
And it happened in the daytime. Guess what? They were right across the street from where Slim and Ibiza got into it right on the corner. That's on across the street on the other corner. Right there, same street, man. Magnolia and Washington, bro. They that all the difference was I wasn't standing right there with Gangsta when that happened. You see what I'm saying? I'm in the second hallway making a sale. You see what I'm saying? When all this just jump off. But you know I keep that bitch on me. Yeah. So while making a little change in the hallway, I hear them bitches. So I see my head out to see what's happening. I just left off that fucking corner with me. I'm Joseph. Magnolia was out there and everything, you dig? So boom. While the nigga hitting him up, I'm like, hold up, man, that's home. And so I go to Iraq. You see, you know how to get in there, man. I go to Iraq and get that dude, you hear me? Dude that took out and woke up running up Washington and hit Clara. Man, I'm behind that boy. Man, I'm on that boy trail. And the whole while, man, you heard me? You did? That was one of the homies. You know what I'm saying? She messed up. And I ain't even know which, and I ain't give a fuck. I had fucked it with him. That's my partner. You know what I'm saying? That was my partner. You did? So fuck. Yes. I don't know what's going on there. I know I can't let no nigga steal no nigga I fuck with. You know what I'm saying? Hell no. I wasn't raised like that.
Right. So you pretty much saved his life that day.
Oh, fucking right. Yeah, I
see
that bitch life, man.
You're
real rap.
For sure.
Real rap.
So, what's some earlier memories you have with you and Ski Boo?
With me and Ski Boo?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Beautiful, man. That's, you got a soldier slam between his eyebrows. I mean, you know what's happening with that, man. That's all. Just because of me all day. There you go. There's no one's happening. Got me and Ski Boo. Man, look. He broken. All American gene before, man. You remember? Ski Boo, I got so many. Man, what? Man, I got so many stories, man. Me, Other Lou, Ski Boo, Wild Child, Law, Red, Double Crosser.
Did you ever? I interviewed Gangsta before, and he told a story about how he stole your Mac 90. Did you ever know who stole your Mac 90 back in the day?
Yeah, I remembered it, but it had been so long to say he had still remembers that you doing the bitch had left the streets here with just, what, 23 years. That's 2 cents away from getting a phone to come out the project for a quarter. So I'm thinking that nigga would remember that shit. That bitch got a strong memory, you heard? See, he had been in a can 23 summers, you heard?
Right.
This call is subject to recording and monitoring.
This is a call from an offender at a Louisiana Department of Corrections facility.
And, you know, you're known for your jokes and everything. So, did you ever get into, like, any altercations off the strength of your joking?
Oh, so many, man. I have found 4 niggas all my life behind me. Judge, because a nigga, nah, nigga can't take that pressure. You know, I got a cold-blooded delivery. You feel me? So, at the end of the day, God gave me this. You know what I'm saying? I feel like God gave me this Judge, man. You know what I'm saying? To keep it pumping, man. You heard me? I'm the one helped create a whole country committee with this mouthpiece, you heard me? And guess who was the first one to get it from me? Slim.
Okay.
I had so many fights, man. I had fights with mice. Man, so many niggas. I could name group of niggas out my hood. I had fights with because they won't go roasting with me, ripping with me, and they can't take that pressure. So many niggas, man. Real rap.
At what age did you realize, you know, you was kind of gifted with the jokes?
What you say?
At what age did you realize you were gifted with the jokes?
Oh, at 6 years old. Mm. Between 6 and 7, I started rounding it up in my mind that I was the one, that I was the chosen one for the new year. I done went against some real motherfuckers that was really out of their mind. You know what I mean? Majority of the niggas who was roses was killers. You know what I'm saying? In my era. You know what I'm saying? Like joking. That's a nigga who called me the game joking. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm coming off that era. I'm 6 and 1 nigga. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? Rest in peace to joking. Fat Larry, August, Claudia V. You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. Type of real niggas I grew up around with. Black Ronald, Ronald Camouche. You know what I'm saying? I stayed next door to Ronald Camouche. Eric Marie stayed on the third floor for me. You know what I'm saying? So I had the best of both worlds, man. You know what I'm saying? My mom on one end, my dad on the other. So by me being my mama, I'm around Claudia B and all the rest of the wild niggas, you know what I'm saying? Eric Maurice and all this, you know. I was witness Eric Maurice go hit a nigga in a cab. You know what I mean? Call the cab to go pull up on a nigga and put a nigga to sleep. You already know what time I need. Rest in peace, homie. I love you, bitch. You dig?
Damn, he pulled up in a cab. So who would you say was like your top 5 in your era, top 5 well-known people coming out the Magnolia?
My famous top 5?
Yeah, like your top 5 street guys coming out the Magnolia.
I'm going to say. Jokey. I'm going to say Ron Camouche. I'm going to say Michael Bullock, my cousin. I'm going to say Eric Maurice. Man, I got some top 5. Lord, you probably see my top 100. There were so many of them, man. There were no Wild Willow with the shoe. Man. Niggas had to come on out here to get guns when they needed them bitches in the know you. You know what I mean? Because we count that on their hardware. We count that real hardware. You feel me? I think we was the first street in the know to get the sticks.
Mm.
That's the way I feel like we were the first person to get sticks on Wild Willow. 6 and Willow, you know what I'm saying? From Willow to the cell, we about out bending. But Wild Willow, man, real rap.
Okay, so how did you get the nickname Logger Black? I know I talked to Johnny Boo before. He called you Chicken.
You have 1 minute left.
He calls you Chicken, but, you know, a lot of people obviously know you as Logger Black.
I got the nickname Long Black the night I wound up serious, keep going doing it like, you heard me, when he had like 9 or 10 niggas that they met with the sticks hitting at him, you heard me, they ain't know I was in the hallway with a stick too, but I'm pumping out the hallway, you heard me, I see the homie and them running, I'm like, oh, look, man, I jump in the action, me, you already know, save my niggas, you know what I'm saying, I go to cutting up too, and the whole while, Slim out there too, but he on the other side of the pool, he get low, you heard me, I don't know he over there with the full nickel, so boom, I don't know what's going on, you dig, so, he changed my name. That bitch changed my name. Bitch, I seen the kid Logger Black hanging me like that on the neck. So, you know, Logger Black is really a snapping turtle. Logger is really a snapping turtle. You feel me? And I always had that mentality. I snap. You know what I'm saying? So, fuck it. I went on. Man, bitch, it's Logger Black. You already know that it's a fuck chicken from now on, man. I actually love eating chicken. I still eat chicken to the day. That's all I won't eat while I'm up here, chicken.
Thank you for using Securus. Goodbye.